Good evening, friends. In the last class, we studied conductance of electrolytic solution. Under this, we studied electrolytic conductance also. Today's class, we are going to discuss about electronic conductance. Electrolytic conductance. This electrolytic conductance is the flow of electricity takes place due to the movement of electrons. That is, the flow of electricity is due to the movement of ions in present in the electrolyte. So in generally in a pure water has low conductivity. Why? Because there is no ions present in it. But when an electrolytes are dissolved in water, there the ions of the solute particles will be moved freely. Moved in the solution, so its conductivity will be increases. The conductivity of electrolytic solution, which will depends on the nature of electrolyte and size of ions produced and their solutions and nature of solvent and its viscosity. Next, concentration of the electrolyte and temperature. In the case of temperature increases, the conductivity also increases. Generally, the mechanism of conductance through semiconductor is more complex. So, if the electrons enter at one end of the metallic conductor and it will go out through the other end, the composition of metallic or electronic conductor remains unchanged. But in the case of passage of direct current, through ionic solution over a prolonged period can lead to change in its composition due to electrochemical reactions. Next, we see measurement of conductivity of ionic solutions. So, here the unknown resistance of the conductor can be measured using Wheatstone bridge. Here we face two major problems. What is the first problem? The passing direct current to the solution, that is, if we are passing DC current to the solution, it will change the composition of solution. And the second problem is the solution cannot be connected directly to the bridge. How can we solve these problems? First problem can be solved by using an alternate current. Instead of DC current, we are applying AC current. And the second problem is solved by using a specially designed vessel called conductivity cell, which has two platinum electrodes coated with the platinum black. Here, the area of cross-section of these two electrodes is A, and they are separated by a distance, that is length L. Thus, the resistance column containing electrolytic solution between the electrodes. Here, resistance is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area of cross-section. We already studied. So, R is directly proportional to L by A. If we remove the proportional, we are writing one proportionality constant. So, R equal to rho into L by A. What is rho? Rho is specific resistance. This 1 by rho equal to kappa, that is specific conductance. So R equal to 1 by K into L by A. Here the quantity L by A is called cell constant. This it is denoted by the symbol G star. G star equal to L by A, that is R into kappa. And the unit of cell constant, G star equal to per meter. Next, we studied measurement of cell constant. How can we measure a cell constant? This type of question will be asked in our PGT chemistry exam. Resistance of the cell can be measured with the potassium chloride solution, whose conductivity at the different temperatures and concentrations are noted. Then the resistance of the electrolyte can be measured by using a cell, that is based on Wheatstone bridge principle. In this figure, R2 is the resistance of the electrolyte to be measured, and R1 is the variable resistance which is adjusted until no current passes through the circuit. R3 and R4 are known as resistance, and O is the source of AC current. AC current means we are supplying alternate power, called oscillator. And if there is no current will be passes or a minimum current passes through the circuit, there is no sound can be heard from the earphone. That is P. P is a detector. When no current passes at that time, R1 by R2 equal to R3 by R4. Here we need to calculate resistance of an electrolyte R2. So what is R1 by R2 equal to R3 by R4? Here cross multiplication, R1 R4 equal to R3 R2. R2 equal to R1 R4 by R3. Once the cell constant and resistance of the electrolyte in the cell are known, the conductivity of the cell is given by kappa equal to cell constant dividing by R. What is the symbol of cell constant? G star by R. The conductivity of the solution depends upon the charge and ions, size of the ions in which they dissociate, and concentration of ions. So in this video lesson, we studied the electronic conductance, that is electrolytic conductance and its principle. Friends, if you like this video, please subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.